All right. I know I've mentioned this a couple of times. I know, I'm facing the wrong direction. It's intentional. Jill. This is Half-Life Alyx, as I have mentioned a couple of times. I've already played through it. I've already beat it. Blah, blah, blah. I'm going to ignore whatever that is, because I do what I want. Look at this. I just want to, like, walk over there and grab that metal bar and ink on it and yell at the wall, because they're taking over the world. Half-Life is one of the greatest games. It's one of the greatest franchises, in my opinion. It was a significant formulating part of my video game childhood-ish. And now, having played it in VR, is probably the single greatest gaming experience of my life. And an excellent new medium of storytelling. Like, I know it's not the same for you watching it on a screen, but me being here, moving around and feeling it, like, I wanted to grab that piece of burned paper that was floating around. Like, you just want to get down here and pick up the rocks and throw them at people and stuff. That's how I broke my ceiling fan, long story. And in Half-Life, that's always been the kind of a thing you can do, you know, pick up that cam. And I thought that was cool as heck, you know, back when Half-Life 2 on the Xbox was getting it on, and it was great. So, for my entertainment, hopefully your entertainment, and maybe me talking science fiction stuff, some panicking, some big ugly aliens, we're gonna do it again. Don't remember. I'm gonna have to play it a third time with the commentary on, because I'm one of those weird people that enjoys the commentary. I remember, did I play on normal or hard last time?
I think you played on normal.
Alright.
Oh.
What?
Cat's gonna get kicked.
That's a cat's problem.
Get. Okay.
Hopefully, you know, this being the first time I'm trying recording VR with my aftermarket generic brand cable and my little 3D printed clip, hopefully you can all hear me appropriately on the mic that's way down there on the desk, because I don't have a fancy mic I can wear, and if I got a nice boom to put my fancy mic on and it's up here, and I'm going to punch it and break it just like I did with my ceiling fan. Long story.
Or break your face.
Yeah, chip a tooth on my mic. That would be my luck. Part of me wants to complain about how long it takes to load this game, or any game in VR, but I'm not going to, because we're still dealing with the limitations of the headset and its processing ability. And I pulled the trigger. That's very bright. Hopefully, my excitedness, you know, my head movement, and I can't see my hands right now, isn't too much for you. And through the magic of YouTube video editing, if anything really egregious happens, you know, cat getting kicked across the room and screaming, whatever.
She left.
I'll edit that out for, depending on how funny it is, I might edit it up. Like I said, this isn't new. Half-Life Alyx has been out for a while. VR's been out for a while. A lot of people have already done this. I've already done this before, you know, privately. But I enjoyed it, and I want to do it again. And especially when I can talk about science, science fiction, and just how I feel like shorter. My boundaries must be messed up. Man, does it look good.
You gonna nerd out again?
Yeah. Why wouldn't I? Being the first time, you know, loading back into this, I know how it works. Chill. I'm busy. Put that away. First time I came back into this, I literally got goosebumps and teary-eyed, like I was back in Half-Life again. And, you know, oh goodness, the striders and dropships and, you know, the cameras, the drones. Bird. AKA government drone. And just how completely immersive and interactive everything is. Like, not only can we read the title on the book, I can pick the book up. And we can recognize who... Thank you, game. Trying to point without accidentally grabbing the thing. Who Dr. Kleiner is. Because we know who Dr. Kleiner is. You know, lore, context. We can even read the spine of it. Since I'm writing a book or two, does he have a legible blurb? Hope you can read it. Mm-hmm. My headset isn't 100% adjusted, so it's a little blurry. Because on odd occasion, my wife uses it. And on often occasions, I do Beat Saber, and I jump around like an idiot. And the settings never really stay put. I can't believe she had this book on the ground. Heinous. There are. Coach. Off-brand cola. And the other fun thing is, there's the bird. Me being a lefty, I can do this. Doop. I'll try not to do this too long or too much, because I know it's kind of boring to those that have watched any Half-Life Alyx, because this is what everybody does in this first little playground area. You get to play around and look at their delicious sustenance bar. Water flavored, because that's a thing. But the attention to detail. You can, I don't know if you can hear that, I can hear that. This insecticide, rattle can, actually rattles. Can I spray it?
No.
Did I shake it up? No. It won't let me spray it. It's all water flavored. What's this? What's this? Gelatinated calorie paste. Egg flavored. I guess that's a little better. Good old electrical tape. I wanted to see this. But apparently.
You can't open it.
Can't open it. Battery's low. I beg to differ. It was like 80% when I started this. So.
Lies!
The physics aren't 100% perfect, but it's the best game in town. Pun intended. I wish I could, like, put this in my wrist pocket that I don't have and save it for later when we meet Jeff. I didn't mean for that to go all the way to the street, but alright. But, you know, to the point of my complete world immersion thing I was getting at. Can adjust the radio here. Maybe I'll get better signal. You can hear it a little bit. I don't know if you can pay attention to the background. But we're not going to use it. Turn it off. Dead out of the way. No. Alright. I can't turn it off. It broke my immersion. It's close, though. But everything, like these rotten apples in this bucket, everything is interactive. And, like, it blew my mind in Half-Life 2 when you could, like, pick stuff up because you had to pick up that can. And now, you still can. And you can pick up a box of matches and rattle them. And then throw them at the guy on the balcony down there. And not throw it far enough because matches aren't heavy enough. Can you pick the flowers? Now that I'm standing on the... No, I can't pick the flowers. Anyway, we're obligated to harass the virtual burbs, right?
Fail.
If I could throw. Can't pick the grass, can't clean the gutter. But, let me do a left hand so I can throw better. I can't actually harass the birds. See, it works great when I do it left-handed. Nope. I can't pick up the leaves. These bags are too heavy. Look. More matches. A different box. The other one had a cat. That one's a rocket. Yeah. Pushing the button. Answering. Call.
Alan! How's it looking up
here? Hi, Dad.
It's good, Dad. Metrocop movement is normal. Same for the combine controls. How's it going in the stock, Dad?
It's a dirty cup.
One combine mini reactor from a shipment of formulas. They're never going to miss it. Here, see for yourself.
And not only that, someone's hacked into the combine construction network.
Don't get greedy, guys. We're not made of time here.
1 minute and I'm out. Guaranteed.
Oh, also, as part of the combine needing supplies and
I can't, like, pull the mic closer to talk into it.
That place is deserted for years.
That is odd. Well, we'll look into it when we get back. Meet back at the same hospital. We'll be there soon.
It looks like.
What is it, Russell?
Would you? Terrific.
Before we meet him the rest of the way, I love Russell. He's no help at all, but he's hilarious. Yeah. Another thing I'm obligated to do, because we're here, and I can... It bothers me that they don't have caps, and so these markers are all going to go to waste. But, I'm a lefty, so... I gotta write something on the wall. Because, like, this is a thing. I can erase that if I want. I don't, because it's beautiful. Sorry, it's part of the game. I'm not going to mess with that.
This time.
I'm going to go over here in the corner and do my own stuff. I don't know what, but I'm going to do it really badly. Throw the marker on the ground. Hi. Right. And, you know, Half-Life has always been a puzzle game, you know. First one, second one, Black Mesa, all the other chapters, all that stuff. There's always puzzles and whatnot. And said open. It doesn't open any wider than that. Lame. Anyway. The puzzles in this game are fantastic. Boop. What's booping? I don't see any. Oh, booping. Why do I need the toggle game menu? I got you. I have done this before. It's going to give us all the training steps since we're in the beginning of the game. So just to make it go away. Pick up the bottle I threw the bird. Turn it to Strider instead. And miss because that was my right. Oh, my God.
done to my roof.
Is insurance going to pay for that?
Does the combine even let you have insurance?
Look, Pot. This is going to make a really satisfying sound. Peak gaming right here. Bug? Do this with the correct hand. No, I can't write on this glass. Weak. Bug. 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 All right. This is bug food. All right, I didn't figure that out the first time. That's cool.
Can you spin the globe?
Pylons. You must construct more pylons. I can't spin the globe. No, there's no America. That's all crossed out. Question mark. Nobody knows about Africa. Nobody knows about Russia, but apparently we've got all this. It's bouncy a little bit. Right here on the border. Australia's got a big fat question mark, too. No, I didn't mean to do that. So this chair just fell through my legs. If we like, we can re-aim our camera. And, you know, I'll stop goofing around. Have a look at his VHS tapes. When was the last time you looked at a VHS? Another great thing about this game.
Give me the clipboard.
Thank you. Both hands. Right? Can't hold it with both hands. I try. But look. Just pointing game, chill. Dog. I love all of the little clues and how much everything is built into everything else. Nope, there's no drawer there to open. But dog. Dog was one of the greatest parts of Half-Life 2. And then again, everything. Get out of the way, Finn. Everything was a good part of Half-Life 2. Alright? See? Dog. I did not know that was there. I just found it. I feel like that should have kept swinging. Button. Thank you. Button. Question. Does it go faster?
No, the lights go out instead.
Sorry, I'll keep going. We'll get some action, though. Before my battery dies, because apparently it's low.
Alex. Mm-hmm. Yep, they got the reactor. Easy peasy. I'm headed back to the safe house right now to meet Dad. Go. We'll be in touch. Stay safe.
You're the one out there. You'll be safe.
to not write poorly. And get a bigger window. We'll put the E over here. Anyway, I did my part. My biggest complaint, I scrunches, is the thumbstick controls here for moving, and the whole like snapping isn't very smooth. But I realize like you're supposed to do it, you know, this way. I wish I could run this without having this cord attached to my computer, and then I can, you know, dance around and turn in circles and not worry about tripping on the cord and breaking things and yoinking everything. Oh, look, a bird. Come here. Ah. Almost got it.
Alex, over here.
What is it?
This doesn't seem like a routine sweep. Are you sure everything went okay?
100%.
Thank you.
Something's got the CPs riled up.
Keep your head down and be smart.
Another small complaint. Whenever you're in a thing, it does that, and now you're all orange. I don't know if it's you see that on your screen, but I see it on my screen. If you stick your head inside a solid object, the screen just goes orange, and it's painful. I'm gonna lose my balance and fall over. And I'm gonna continue harassing the birds. Around this corner here. Nothing going on. Can't see me. Alright. Gate's locked.
Mercy, cat. You're good. She's out of the way.
Alright. I gotta stay facing the right direction. My apologies. It's gonna happen a lot. I know I was recently talking about how I'm gonna do. And by the time this gets uploaded, I should have, for a couple of weeks, been doing half-hour-long episodes four times a week instead of hour-long episodes twice a week. I'm just going to go for as long as I'm going to go, and then I can manually chop it up to the right length later, because I'm unprofessional like that. It's part of the charm. You don't have to deal with all those ads and end screens and disabled phones. And stuff. It is fluffy. Portal storm. Likely negotiations of peace. Is there a date? Terrible. Yeah, I don't see a date. That'd be cool. I'm sure there is one. I just don't know what it is.
Don't forget to put the cone on your head.
I've already got the achievement for that, though. But, yes.
Fine, then. Don't put the cone on your head.
For proof that you can. I now have a helmet. Does it, like, flop off?
Nope. Mm-mm. Not unless a head crab eats you.
I can't even knock it off on the wall here. Look like a goat rubbing my head on stuff. Yeah, but now that you have a helmet, it protects you from the barnacles. Because it's going to grab that and not you. Hey, there was a cat. And she slammed the door in my face. Without a knob. There was a cat! We're obligated to break in now. You must pet the cat.
Oh, look, birds.
Stressing the birds. I know how to climb ladders, thank you. That part was always in the locker room. But it does save you doing some weird vaulting thing. Peak gaming. That sounded fantastic. It looked fantastic. Now, I know I've mentioned it multiple times already. I've played through this once before, even if it was on an easier difficulty. So I kind of know what's going on, but I'm not gonna lie. A lot of this stuff A lot of this stuff took a long time to figure out the first time. And made me look like an idiot. And I'm sure it will happen again. Hi, guys.
Whoa. Wait. I just live here.
Run away, anti-citizen. Get those hands off.
Wait.
They're already up.